Time for some questions.
We have some questions?
Let's go.
This is Kathy. She says, I have been married for 20 years, but I'm at the point of a love-hate relationship with my husband. I have prayed for him, but I dread seeing him come home from work. What should I do? I'm so tired. She doesn't say why.
She doesn't say what he's doing, but I hate him. I don't know what's... I'm a great believer in couples going away to another location, get away from the house, get away from the humdrum, get away from work, spend a time together, just the two of you, and relax and see if you can't rekindle the love that you had before. That thing is in bad shape, but I won't tell you to go to some counselor. Just get away.
And talk with each other. Yeah. Really, honestly.
But, I mean, have fun. If you like to sail boats, sail boats. If you want to fish, fish. If you want to hike in the woods, hike in the woods. If you want to, you know, play with a dog, do that. Do something. I mean, ride a horse, you know, ski, whatever you do, swim, something. But get away.
I agree.
All right.
This is Marvin, who says, I'm a worship leader. A man asked me if he could play the guitar for our worship group. He's very talented and loves the Lord. However, he has several visible tattoos, some very offensive from before he became a Christian. I'm not sure if he should be in front of the church. I really don't know how to handle this situation.
Let him do it and enjoy the tattoos. And if it's really offensive, it's some nasty thing on it, I mean, just get, say, look, Charlie, there's a satanic thing. Cover it up.
Yeah.
Wear a shirt. Mm-hmm. Let him, I mean.
He's been redeemed.
He's been redeemed, and that'll show grace. And the people, you might have some young kids in the audience that think that's really cool. So it may be that'll win them. Don't be scared of that.
This is Robert, who says, I have a problem with many churches today. They have loud bands and sing simple, repetitive songs. The Bible says to sing hymns. These aren't hymns. I've also noticed children running up and down aisles with no adult supervision and people bringing food and drinks into the sanctuary. Have people forgotten this is God's house?
Well, the Bible says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Serve the Lord
and
with singing.
And they did eat on the mount.
You know, I remember Catherine Kuhlman, God bless her, said, I think we're getting too familiar with God. And we really are. I mean, would you go into the Buckingham Palace for an audience with the Queen in muddy boots and a scraggly beard without being washed in clothes? Of course not. You'd wear your best clothes and you'd dress up. You're coming into the presence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You know, the old-time priests, they had various rules of the way they dressed, and if they violated from those, they were in trouble. I do think it's time to, you know, shape up. We've gone too far with this casual. Yeah. I mean, casual's good, but I'm with you as some of that music I can't stand. They call it worship. It drives me nuts. Really, I just can't stand it.
Well, you know, a lot of churches, and I think this is really good, a lot of churches do a balance between the more contemporary worship songs and the hymns of the centuries that have meant so much to the church, and I think it's a nice combination.
I had the privilege a few years ago of attending seminary, and one of the things we had was a course on worship. And what the idea is you build up the worship, you know, little by little, at various phases, to a point where you're offering yourself, and actually offering is the giving yourself or an invitation to something. But just going on with music, one after the other, they don't tie together, they don't lead to some commitment, they don't lead to some expression of love for God. It's just more noise, not cool.
I think a good worship leader does have them lead to something.
Yeah.
There is a line and a message.
We had for our CBN, little function yesterday, Gary Spell, who's a master.
Awesome.
He's awesome. But he's a real musician. But otherwise, it's just you sing the song and you think, oh, this is a climax. And then you come back and you go to, you're down. And then you come up. And it's just cacophony. And all right, you've heard from your fondest critic.